צהריים טובים, ברוכים הבאים לכולל אהבת ישראל. היום אנחנו נלמד שיעור מסילת ישרים, פרק 7. Thank you everybody for coming, כולל אהבת ישראל. Thanks for watching us. בעזרת השם, we're going to do the righteous path of the righteous from the Ramchal. It's the 6 classes. We are at chapter 7 right now. And בעזרת השם, as usual, we want to first and foremost dedicate this class in honor of our sponsor, Mr. and Mrs. Bernie and Zavid Baruch. Refuah shlema to Bernie Baruch, Ben Chaya Miriam, Be'ezat Hashem, and to Dr. Ephraim and Susan Kahana. Refuah shlema to Ephraim Ben Devora, and Be'ezat Hashem to Flori Bat Rachel. Refuah shlema to Anat Bat Zizel, Chaim Ben Raymond, יעקב בן גניה, יניב מאיר בן חנה אנט, מרדכי בן אסתר, עינב בת שרה, בנימין בן נתן, רחל יפרח, נתן בן יגאל, שירין, נחמן בן רות, אדליה בת שרה, ויולטה בת דורה, בת שבע בת רבקה, ומיכל בת רוחמה. ובעזרת השם, לעילו נשמת אבי מורי ניסים דהן, אמי מורתי רחל דהן, אחי מאיר אברהם יעקב, לעילו נשמת שרה בת קלרה, נחה בת אסתר, יהודה אריה בן שרה, פרוספר סללי בן אליס, שמחה בת שרה, וברוך גבריאל בן שרה. אז בעזרת השם, we continue במסילת ישרים בעניין ביאור חלקי הזריזות. So, you know, we know that there is a very important mitzvah to rush to a mitzvah. One of the mitzvah is זריזות, לעשות מצווה. כתוב זריזים מקדימים למצווה. Meaning that the people that in a rush to do a mitzvah, but in order to do a mitzvah in a fast way, you have to really understand first not to make mistakes, because, you know, as we know, fools rush in, right? There is a term in English, אנשים שרצים מהר לפעמים עושים טעויות. You cannot rush in unless you know how to first do everything correctly. So it says the Ramchal, זכרונו לברכה, he says, חלקי הזריזות שניים, אחד קודם למעשה ואחד לאחר המעשה. He says that there is two parts to being careful, and I'm sorry, to be fast to do the mitzvah. And he said there is two parts. One, exercising the being careful before the beginning of this mitzvah, the good deed, and one after. He says, what does it mean before? קודם התחלת המעשה הוא שלא יחמיץ האדם את המצווה. So for an example, the Ramchal says, you're not allowed to, חס וחלילה, miss a mitzvah. You know, when הקדוש ברוך הוא provides you an opportunity to do a mitzvah, there's a big secret behind it. The Zohar הקדוש says, if חס וחלילה, you know, a poor guy comes to you, and I say חס וחלילה, it's not for you to be a poor guy. He says it's better to be from the givers than the receivers, right? If a poor guy that, you know, חס וחלילה became poor, and he comes to you, let's say out of nowhere, you know, a person come, knock on your door and says, I need tzedakah, please. Of course, Jewish guy. They said that this person coming specifically to you was a person from your family in the past life that you need to do a tikkun that he did not help before. This is also the Arizal mentioned that in Sefer HaGilgulim. And as we know, everything that we do here in this world is to come to do a tikkun, as we mentioned. And he says, Kodem HaMaseh, in order to be fast, you have to never give an opportunity to miss a mitzvah. Because sometimes this mitzvah could be the one that could change your life and the life of others, and perhaps even your location and place in Gan Eden. There is a story from one of the big rabbi in Yerushalayim that used to actually, very, very big mekubal, Rabbi Ptaya, and he used to see people in their reincarnation, just like the Arizal was. And he says that one day a lady came to him, a Yemenite lady, that told him, you know, there's a very bad things happen. A mitzvah came my way, and I picked up this fig, and I did a bracha, but I made a mistake. I did the fig, a bracha of Adama. You know, fig is from the tree, and I did a bracha of Adama. And that night, says, my cousin came to me in his dream, in my dream, and started yelling at me all night, how dare you do this mitzvah not correctly? That was my last tikkun. I came as a fig. You know, the gilgulim, you can come as a person, you can come as an animal, you can come as a plant, you can come as a fish, you can come like all levels, chay tzomech domem, all the levels of, you know, even a rock, you can come back. The Zohar HaKadosh says, your gilgul is better be as not a person, anything else, because, you know, as a person you have a lot of challenges. But if, let's say, you have you're a fish, you know, you live as a rock, you know, this is your gilgul, it's not as terrible, because you have no choices. Only mankind have real choices, so to speak. So this lady came to the Rabbi Pataya, and she told him the story, and that this neshama came to her and says, you ruined my, I was about to go, this is the last mitzvah I needed to for my tikkun, the bracha on, you know, I came back in a fig, and you messed it up. You said, Baruch Atah Hashem, Borei Pri Adama. She apologized. So she went to Rabbi Pataya, and Rabbi Pataya says, you have to do it again if that's the tikkun. By the way, it's a footnote, just so you know, if you ever, you know, encounter a tree that's not ripe yet, a fruit of the tree. Let's say, for an example, you're very hungry, you're walking between town to town, you see an orange tree that the orange is green, you actually bless Adama on it, not Etz. Only ripe fruit, ripen fruits, you do the bracha of Etz. If it's not ready, when it's really in a growth stage, of, it's considered Adama yet. So continue the Arizal, and it says, how you not, you know, if a mitzvah come to you, bizmana or bizdamna lefanecha or be'alutcha b'machshava, yemaher yachish ma'aseh ulechoz ba ve'lasot otah. He says, when a mitzvah come your way, it's no coincidence. Hashem from the heavens send you this mitzvah. Don't pass on it. You know, many people, chaz v'chalila, whenever they see a poor person, immediately they have this, chaz v'chalila, almost a bad look in their face. Like, what is this guy? He's been here before, he's coming again, or this, or that. Chaz v'chalila, chaz v'chalila, not allowed. If when Hashem sends somebody for you to do a mitzvah, in any, it doesn't have to be tzedakah. Somebody asks you for help. Somebody says, come do this for me right now. I need your help. Lend me some money right now. I need it. This is a very, very big mitzvah that was sent your way. Do not miss it. Chaz v'chalila say, if you miss a mitzvah, maybe you will never come back again. And that was your tikkun, because you never know. Secharam shel mitzvot. Even David HaMelech says, I wish I knew which mitzvah is more and less of a sachar. And of course we know that all mitzvah, sachara mitzvah, the rewards of a mitzvah is a mitzvah. Of course there's not enough room in this world to, you know, even hold the amount of gratitude and rewards you will have for the mitzvah you do all your life. Continue the Ramchal, says, even if you think of a mitzvah, let's say you thought of a helping, you heard of a person that need, like for an example, we had a horrific story here in La Jolla, few days ago, a person that used to live here, a doctor with his three kids and his wife, moved up north, and the father and the son went on a camping trip in Lake Tahoe, and out of nowhere this guy comes and shoot the father, and the son both, the father died instantly, the son, 15 years old boy, runs to hide for 30 hours, he's hiding in the wilderness. And he reaches a high peak, finally get a signal and call the police. And you know, my friend, you know, one of our Chavruta from La Jolla sent me the story. And immediately we need to help this family. Now there is a mother that has cancer, Elohim Yishmor, and she has three kids and the husband is dead. And now she needs to raise three kids, she needs to support herself. So they put together a GoFundMe. When Hashem says, I want you to help, here's an opportunity. No matter what you can do, do it. It's a big, big mitzvah to help an orphanage and a widow. They say that there is no greater mitzvah than to help Ger Tzedek, Almana, ve'yatom. Those are the three things, the three people that Hashem personally guaranteed their safety. They say, Chas v'chalila, if you ever mess up with a widow, if you mess up with an orphan, or with Ger Tzedek, I will make you all of those, Chas v'chalila. So there's a result to the mitzvah is really, in essence, such a character trait that you have to build within you. And never says, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it later, somebody else will do it. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu give you this opportunity, run, take it. Because you can only own the mitzvah, nobody can own it, right? When you do a mitzvah, it's yours to keep forever. And Kamuvan, we said, the Zohar says every mitzvah you make is an angel for you. Malachi Sharet. Continue the Ramchal and says, כי אין סכנה בסכנתו, אשר הינה כל רגע שמתחדש, יוכל להתחדש איזה עיכוב למעשה הטוב. חס וחלילה, it says, don't delay a mitzvah, because sometimes, as I mentioned before, it becomes a סכנה, it could be something dangerous that you will not be able to do again. So we see here that really, in essence, the Ramchal says, וכל אמיתת זה הדבר, ירוני זכרונם לברכה, בעניין המלאכת שלמה, שאמר דוד לבנייהו. So we know that David המלך, our sages explain, it's of course in the book, in the Tanakh, in Melachim, and it says that David המלך asked Hashem, when he's going to die? Can you tell me, Hashem, please? And Hashem says, we don't say that. We don't tell you when, we don't even tell you where, we don't tell you anything. This is something that, you know, כי ימות אדם ואוהלו. You know, you never know. Whenever you die, you should be with Hashem. We know Adam was a reincarnation. I mean, David המלך was a reincarnation of Adam. Adam gave him 7 years from his life. And David המלך will be from him will come Mashiach. Hence the letters of Adam is Adam, David, Mashiach. And David המלך finally convinced Hashem to tell him, when will I die? So Hashem says, how about, you know, David המלך, how about the day? Forget the dates. And it says, how about what day? So Hashem revealed to him, it will be on Shabbat. אמר לו הקדוש ברוך הוא בשבת. So David המלך says, let me die on Friday so I don't do חילול שבת from my family. Hashem says, no. He says, how about let me die Sunday? Hashem says, no, it's your first kingship of your son, Shlomo. So he says, no, so let me, you know, do that. Hashem says, no. He says, טוב לי תורת פיך מאלפי קורבנות. He says to him, I love your Torah more than 1,000 sacrifices in the Mikdash that your son is going to build. And as we know, David המלך died on Shabbat, and Satan was able to distract him, making noise in the tree, and David המלך died. But before that, he told his, what we call, loyal servant, the loyal, it was the head of the Sanhedrin, his name, Bnayahu. Bnayahu ben Yehoyada, as we know. He was unbelievable righteous, and he's the one that was able to trick Ashmedai. He was actually an advisor both to David HaMelech and to Shlomo HaMelech, and he's the one that was able to capture the, you know, the kings of all Shedim, king of all demons, Ashmedai. So he says to him, in Melachim, ואורתם אותו אל הגיחון, וענה בניהו, אמן כן יהי רצון. Meaning, when David המלך, because we know David המלך, he had 20 boys and one girl, right? He had 18 wives, meaning he had 8 wives and 10 concubines, and he had 20 boys and one girl. And of course, we know that Bathsheba was the mother of Shlomo. And even though, just so you know, technically Bathsheba was the original shidduch to David HaMelech, but he gave it to Uriah Hitti. But when it's time come to now announce the next king, he told his head of Sanhedrin, I want you to take him, you know, and saying that, take him to the Gihon, you know. The Gihon was a river that's actually, as you know, the word, you know, Maim Chaim, in order to do the mikveh, in order to anoint him and put, you know, everything that he needs to do for the kingship. Kam Rabbi Pinchas, Beshem Rabbi Hanan de Tzipori. You know, Rabbi Pinchas comes and says, in the name of Rabbi Hanan, which is, by the way, is a big segula to bring Mashiach. When you quote a rabbi or where you learn it from, you have to say where you learn it from. Is a beautiful segula to bring Mashiach. And we learned this from none other than Esther HaMalka, when Mordechai told her that there is the Biktan Vateresh wants to kill, the two guards want to kill Ahasuerus. She went to him and she said, I heard the two of your guards want to kill you. Mordechai told me. She didn't say just myself. It says Mordechai told me. By that we know that it's a big mitzvah to say who told you. So come Rabbi Pinchas b'shem Rabbi Hanan de Tzipori from the mount, from the city of Tzipori. He says, Hine ben nolad lecha hu yeh ish menucha. The announcement that the nevuah that came to David HaMelech was, there's a son coming to you, will be a son of peace. As we know, Shlomo, the name Shlomo, hu hashalem, is full, is menucha. That's why he brought 410 years of menucha la'olam. He brought 410 years of Beit HaMikdash. Ve'e said that, Ela harbe kitrugin yamdu mikan ve'ad ha'gichon. And David HaMelech says in Divrei HaYamim, that between now and then, there will be a lot of people that Chas v'Chalila will say bad things. Because you know, David HaMelech, for 29 years he was hiding. People want to kill him for 29 years. You know, his father-in-law, his own son Avshalom, his generals, all kinds of things. By the way, there was one general that was loyal to him, and his name was, we use it until today, Chashai. His Chashai was the general that went into Avshalom and led him to the wrong path. And until today we use, you know, the Israeli secret service called Sherut HaChashai, the secretive, because he was such a good spy. And he was able to fool the whole generals and military and his Avshalom and everybody. And we know at the end Avshalom was speared by 10 spears and he was caught with his hair because of the 10 commandments that he broke, every one of them. And of course, he always used his beauty to justify such a thing. He says, that's why when David HaMelech says to Bnaya, I want you to do it, don't wait. Because by doing that, that's why we don't machmitzim et ha-mitzvah, we shmartem et ha-mitzvot, we keep the mitzvot, that means we even do it when it comes, even though you don't think it's the right time, you do it. He says, Chas v'chalila, make sure you're always in the knowledge that mitzvah haba liyadcha al tachmitzena, do not allow yourself to lose a mitzvah. Ve'amru, our sage says in Masechet Nazir, le'olam yakdim adam lidvar mitzvah. For an example, there's a beautiful segula, they say, to be the first one in shul for a minyan. Early in the morning, of course, you know, before tzetach hama, it's good to come down to go up, usually, you know, Bet Knesset, you always go up. There's a beautiful teaching about that. It says a mitzvah to be the first one. The one to open the shul is really a huge, huge mitzvah. It's rizim la mitzvah, it's a person. She, you know, even said the minyan start at 6:30 every morning, like we have here outdoors. It's good to come at 6:15, you know, put your tefillin and put your tzitzit on and do some divrei Torah and learn a little bit and be prepared for tefillah. As we said, tefillah beli kavana is a goof beli neshama. It's important to have a tefillah that you really pay attention to what you pray and don't wander off with your thoughts about the stock market or about this and my house this and my son need this and my wife needs this, or my friend. Leave that aside. Tefillah is petila, right? It's like the candles. You have to have the oil and you have to have the wick in order to light up. The two of them combined works. If you have one missing, it's not good. So continue, Kadosh Baruch Hu, and teach us in Masechet Nezirim, שלפי שהקדימה בחירה לצעירה. You know, we know that even חס וחלילה, the enemy number one of Israel, Lavan, right? Lavan was the father-in-law of Yaakov. Even he understood the Zrizuto mitzvah. Yaakov Avinu originally made a deal with him about Rachel. And he says, specifics, I want your daughter, the young one, Rachel. Specific, because he knew Leah was set up originally for Esav, and Leah was the Bechira, the Bechora. But we know that even though Yaakov worked for 7 years, he rushed to the mitzvah to marry Leah. You know, no matter how that he cheated him and everything, but he says, you know what, this is what Hashem wants, Zrizut la mitzvah. By the way, that was the reason Yaakov bought the Bechorah. The Bechorah is not just the rights to do mitzvot, it's also to marry Leah HaBechorah, to marry Leah, the firstborn of Lavan. Right? Of, you know, Rivka, as we know, that was her brother. And her father Putiel died. He was like Saddam Hussein, by the way, this Putiel. Yimach Shmo V'Shem Zichro and La Gaddafi. They used to rape all the brides, the pretty brides, on the wedding nights. That was their thing, like from Putiel. Putiel used to do that. This is the father of Lavan. But even from this kind of home, Me'az Yatza Matok, Rivka came, Holy of Holies. From even a bad, bad place, to show you, no matter where you are, don't ever give up. Don't ever think I come from a bad family. Don't ever think, you know what, look, my father, my mother, my brother. No, it's up to you. We are all individuals. Never generalize. Never, ever, ever, ever think that you cannot come back from any sin. They say that, you know, there's always tshuva, sha'are tshuva, and sha'are dim'a lo nina'alu. So continue, it says, ואפילו זריזים מקדימים למצוות, וכן אמרו, לעולם ירוץ אדם לדבר המצווה, ואפילו בשבת. He says, you know, you have to rush to a mitzvah. You know, on Shabbat, it's a mitzvah not to do anything like you do during the weekdays. Like, you don't, it's better not to sweat on Shabbat or run. But when it comes to a mitzvah, it's actually allowed. In Masechet Brachot, it says that the person that rush to do a mitzvah, even if he has to run on Shabbat, is a mitzvah. Even though it's considered mundane. And it's also in the Midrash, it says, Hu yigan yinhagenu almut. You know what? Hu yinhagenu almut. You know, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, they say when a person dies to do a mitzvah, not really, you're not allowed to die, of course, for only three things. The only three things you're allowed to give up your life is chas v'chalila, murder, is, you know, cheating with, you know, somebody else's wife or so, or idolatry. For everything else you should live. He says, when hu yinagenu almut is really what it means, that you are bizrizut. This is you even die for it to do a mitzvah. He says here, continue, ke'ilin olmata, ke'ma de'at amar v'toch olamot tofefot, ke'azrizut imidat shelemut. A person that rush to mitzvah is really shalem. We know Shlomo HaMelech, he was anointed as a king when he was 12 years old. Hashem says to him on Mount Gibeon, is the same mountain that Joshua stopped the sun, you know. Amazing. Joshua was able to stop the sun, the whole universe, until he finished the war. That was Mountain Gibeon, you know. On the same mountain, Shlomo HaMelech, Hashem came to him and says that night, now that you became a king, what can I do for you? What do you want? And Shlomo HaMelech says, I just want to know how to judge the people correctly so I don't make mistake. Meaning that really, this is a 12-year-old, he can ask for all the wealth in the world, all the whatever. Hashem says to him, because you only ask for the good, the Shlemut, I'll give you everything else. And we know Shlomo HaMelech was the richest man in the world. But let's continue. He says here that has resulted in midat shlemut. You know, the person that fill holes, he rush to a mitzvah because he knows that he'll never lose. You know, when people rush to do a mitzvah, it's always from the knowledge that they're not really there to do anything to be rewarded here. It's not for that. The reward is a mitzvah. In the Gemara says in Masechet Avot, it's in Olam Haba. It's not really here. Everything that you benefit from here is really tzedakah from Hashem. And it's because of the merit of your good mitzvot, of the rush to a mitzvot, of mitzvot that you do quietly, the chesed, a certain mitzvot that yesh lahem chelek leolam haba, veyesh secharam ba'olam hazeh. You have to understand that our path is really is mitzvot all the time. When the Tana says sur mera va'aseh tov, in the Gemara also, what's sur mera va'aseh tov? Meaning that everything that's asur, sur, move away from it. Everything that's bad, forbidden. Everything that's mutar is the mitzvah, right? Aseh tov, it's mutar. It's mutar, that means, you know, asur is somebody that's hands are cuffed, right? It's asur, it's tied. When you do a mitzvah, you mutar, you're open, you're free. It says here, מי שמתגבר ותופס בה כל מה שיוכל, הנה לעתיד לבוא יזכה לה באמת. It says, a person that does anything to make the mitzvah, They say even a poor person has to give tzedakah. Even if he doesn't have much. You got a dollar, give 10 cents. They say that, you know, don't be a fool. Many people give $1 tzedakah. You know, I don't know if you know, today you can barely buy anything with unless you have $20. Don't worry, whatever you give, Hashem will give you tenfold. Guaranteed, guaranteed. Asir shetit asher. When you give tzedakah, you become rich. When Hashem gives you a cup full of water to you and your friend, and your friend keep pouring and giving others, that means he's getting more filled up for him. If you keep your water at full level, that's it, all you get, one cup of water. You can get 100 cups of water from one cup. Always give and rush to a mitzvah. Then tzedakah, because tzedakah tatzil mimavet. And we are in a very, very auspicious days right now. We are in Ben HaMetzarim. You know, Ben HaMetzarim is the days between Yud Zayin Betamuz, which is the fast today, until Tisha B'Av. Those, says the Gemara, says, if you want to reach Beyamim Elei Siguha, those are the days when you can reach the understanding of the Torah and the mitzvot. So rush to it, especially now, this 21 days. It says here, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Yitna lo secharo chelef ma sheishtadel achareya bizman avodato. It says Hashem not just give you the sechar for the mitzvah, the reward, it gives you even for the work that you did towards it. You know? So Be'ezat Hashem, do everything you can and find mitzvot. Don't just sit there and say, oh, I didn't know, I didn't come across any mitzvot. Believe me, there's many, many things you can do and find, especially in our community in San Diego. We know a lot of people, sick people that, you know, come here for transplant, or their families, they need help, or other community members, the old people that have no, they can't even leave the house, they need meals. There's a lot of mitzvot to do. Even Bikur Cholim, or just say hello, call. And if you need some, call me, I'll be happy to supply you. And we have on our website, nesatorah.org, we have a section of the mitzvah. You can go to that page. There's so many things you can help with. God bless you if you want. It'll be a great thing. Everything 100% goes to mitzvot. It says, "Achazrizut achar atchalat ha-ma'asehu." When a person is zariz, you know, after he begins to do, kevan she'achaz ba-mitzvah. That's already given you achiza in the mitzvah. You are owner of this mitzvah. They say even sometimes, even you were thought of doing a mitzvah and you rush and somebody else came and did it before you, you get the sachar of a full mitzvah. By the word sachar in Hebrew is reward. Sachar is also kasher. When you do mitzvah, that means you're full kasher. Yemaher la'ashlim otah ve'lo la'akel me'alav. He says, rush to it and don't say to others, oh, maybe this guy will do it. There's 20 people here. Somebody else will pick up this mitzvah. He says, chaz ve'chalila, a person doesn't do it, he doesn't really deserve to receive anything from Hashem. He says, on the other end, כפי שמתהווה להשלים מעליו מסעו, אלא מירתו פן לא יזכה לגמור אותה. He said, זה חס וחלילה, you have to think about it. This is like something you're going to carry with you, and you don't want to miss it. You want to miss a bag of diamonds. Hashem says, here, I'm giving you diamonds. You know, you're collecting, I don't know, bitcoins, or you're collecting shoes or cars or whatever it may be. Hashem says, I'm giving you diamonds upon diamonds. Yahalom is not a mistake that it's called in Hebrew. Yahalom is Hashem halom. Hashem give you that, you know. This is Elohim, right? The word Elohim has the word Yahalom in it. It's a diamond. This is the mitzvah that I'm giving you are better than Tov li Torat picha me'alfei zahav v'kesef. It's better than all the gold in the world, all the money in the world. It says, don't worry, people that don't have emunah, they really are people that have less. I'll give you an example. There's a story in Muncie. My rabbi, one of my dear, dear friend, Rabbi Yossi, he always used this story. It was an unbelievable miracle. He had two Baalei Tshuva. You know, one of them was Lior Edri. And Lior Edri, he did such Tshuva. It was like one of the most beautiful Tshuva this yeshiva ever seen. He was so dedicated to the mitzvot and Torah learning and everything. And his parents, you know, many parents, when you say, I made tshuva, they're like, what's wrong? What happened? They always think that something bad happened. It's actually a great thing. You know, it's a very, very good thing. So they came to America to visit him. So, you know, in Muncie, it's not very fancy places and stuff. So he set them up with a place to be hosted and everything for the Shabbat and everything. And, you know, they were so pleased with him. But they said, what about Parnassah? And what about this? What about this?
you know, the whole 2 weeks they're like, you know, trying to say, okay, you can learn, but go work too, and don't just do tshuva. There's other things in the world. But 2 weeks goes by, and they have to go now back to JFK, to the airport. It's, you know, Sunday night. The father goes to the son, son, listen, you know, we need a big car for tomorrow, because, you know, the two of us, each one has two big suitcases, your mother bought some stuff, we have all these things. And, you know you don't have a car, but, you know, we need a big car, and, you know, please take care of it. So the son, 11 o'clock at night, says to his father, Abba, לא לדאוג, הקדוש ברוך הוא יטפל בהכל, הוא יודע מה אנחנו צריכים. He says, Father, don't worry, Hashem knows that you need to go back to Israel, Mama. Hashem knows that I don't have a car. Hashem will help, don't worry. And he went to sleep. The father and mother were freaking out all night, cannot fall asleep. What's going to happen? We're going to miss our flight. I have to leave at 5 o'clock in the morning. You know, at 4:30 in the morning, Lior Edri, this tzaddik, goes to do a mikvah. He was such a baal tshuva, he would do a mikvah every day in this kollel in Mansi, Rabbi Yosef Mizrahi. He says, at 4:30 in the morning, he does a, you know, he goes to the mikveh. And all of a sudden, you know, dark at night, and, you know, 4:30 in the morning, his buddy comes in. I don't remember his buddy's name. I think it's Duros, something like that. And his buddy's business is also Baal Tshuva, very, very good Baal Tshuva. He actually buy and trade used cars online, and sometimes, you know, he uses them. Now, I don't know if you ever know, but to buy a used car from an auction, you never know whether you can get a horrific car or you can get a good car. You never know, because you don't see it. It's online. But this guy, this other friend that was such a Baal Tshuva too, that was his business. So he says, listen, I do my share. I go to Kollel and I study all day and I do tshuva. Whatever car I buy, Hashem will take care of it. Make sure it's a good car. Be'ezat Hashem. So, you know, Lior says to his buddy, he says, you know, I have to take my parents to the Kollel, to the airport today, JFK, and right now after Shachrit, and I don't have a car. Elohim Yishmor, I hope by Be'ezat Hashem, Hashem will do a miracle. So he looks at him, he smiles, says, well, he did. He says, you know, I usually never bring cars here, I just sell them. But Friday, I brought this car, here's the key. Go use it, take them to the airport and come back. He goes out, a beautiful large minivan that can fit everything. He takes them back to the airport and come back. So they ask him, how do you have such a, you know, amazing emunah? He says, this is the difference between shlemut and not. This is the difference between full and not being full in emunah of Hashem. Hashem knows what we want. I said to Hashem, I need a car. You know what I do. I study. I take care. You know, this. You do your share. I went to sleep without any fear. He says people that fear have to go to work. That's what Rabbi Yossi says. A person that doesn't have emunah, that if you'll study Torah enough to, you know, earn olam haba kmo shetzarich, has to go to work too. You know, the Chafetz Chaim says the perfect day has, you know, as we know, 24 hours. It says the Chafetz Chaim, it's okay. You can work for 8 hours, study for 8 hours, and go to sleep for 8 hours. That's the perfect combination if you really have to work and if you cannot handle learning more. Continue the Ramchal and says, ועל זה ירבו להזהיר זכרונם לברכה. Our sages always, you know, give us warning. When, you know, when our sages, when we say Chazal, many people take it lightly. Chazal, Chachamenu zechonam lebracha, those are people that could stop a tsunami with their hand, that can wake up a dead person, that can create earthquake with their hands. Those are Tanaim, those are people that wrote the Mishnayot, those are people that, the Amoraim, that gave us the Halachot from the Gemara. When they say something, it's not to be taken lightly. Many people say Chazal and they think, ah, it's just a rabbi somewhere. No, it's speaking of such greatness. Kol ha-matchil be-mitzvah ve-eno gomer ota, kover ishto uvanav. I'm going to say that again, both in English and in Hebrew. It's a very, very unbelievable what they say. They say, whoever begins a mitzvah and does not complete it, buries his wife and his children. Chaz v'chalila. Meaning that if you start a mitzvah even if your mind, you're about to do a mitzvah and then you stopped and you know what, I say, I'm going to do something else. I'm not going to do this mitzvah. Chas v'chalila, that comes from Bereshit Rabbah, by the way, in the Midrash. He says you'll end up burying your kids and your wife, meaning you'll be alone in this world. It's horrific. They say that, you know, chas v'chalila, the nature of the world is never for kids to die before their parents. You know, the normalcy of, you know, our world should be that the children bury their parents and not vice versa. So they say here, chas v'chalila, they are putting an emphasis. It says, en ha-mitzvah nikret ella al shem gomra. The mitzvah is really, why it's the mitzvah? Because you finally did the tzivui of Hashem. Mitzvah, right? It's mehashem tzivah. HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave you this mitzvah, and you do a tzavta. Then you finish it by connecting what Hashem says and what you do physically. That's how you really, he says, the one that finished the mitzvah is the one that owns the mitzvah. Ve'amar Shlomo HaMelech, Alav HaShalom, King Solomon says in the book of Mishlei, Chaziti ish mahir b'melachto, lifnei melachim mityatzev. Ba'al yityatzev lifnei chashuchim. He says that, you know, Shlomo HaMelech in the book of Mishlei, he says something like this. Have you ever seen a man with the alacrity of his work? He will stand before kings, and he will not stand before darkness. When a person is really good at what he does, right? A person is charutz, a person that really does the best, is usually the one that gets the best part. You know, you're standing in the presence of a CEO, a vice president, you like the best, you know, of what they can offer to their employees. So here too, the same thing. When you do that, when you chazita ish mahir b'melachto, a person that does good work, yityatzev lifnei melachim, meaning the Melech Malchei HaMelachim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He says, our sages continue and says, Yechaso lo hashevach hazeh al shemiher. He says, even in the heavens, they give you such reward that you rush to do the mitzvah. Bebinyan v'melachat binyan habayit. This is like building of the temple, as if, you know, many as we know, when the second temple by Zerubbabel and the Nevi'im, we know that originally it wasn't the same temple that is the second built and been remodeled, so to speak. They say, you know, they built it. I don't know if you've ever been to Yerushalayim, and I hope you have. If not, you got to make a trip to that. You know, the temple, we call it Temple Mount. You know, I call it Temple Mount because the Arab sitting on top right now. Stupid. But in reality, Temple Mount is the highest mountain of all Yerushalayim, right? And some says it's highest of all the mountains surrounding even the whole area. And if you look from Yerushalayim to the lowest point is Yam HaMelach, right? The Dead Sea is 400 meters below sea level, and Har HaMoriah is above all. Later on, when Herod, because you know Herod originally destroyed and killed many Jews, and he had a prophecy, Hashem came to him in a dream. It's written through several books that Hashem says to him, for what you did, you will die and all, and you will suffer and all your family in it. So he did tshuva that night, and the next morning he decided to fix and elevate Har HaMoriah. And he's the one that actually took every day 24,000 people to bring sand and just to plateau the mountain. And just so you know, they say every day there were 10,000 Zrizim La Mitzvah. There was 10,000 Jewish people that rushed, even though they were poor and hungry and everything, they rushed to build the new temple, because he promised them, he says, this will be the temple of Hashem, that will be the best of all things that the Roman built. And exactly, we know that he built such a temple, the Tiferet. It was such an amazing in awe of all, one of the most beautiful buildings. Some say it was even more beautiful than the building of Shlomo HaMelech, you know, the first temple. But in reality, this result of so many people to build this, they finish it in 1.5 years. Shlomo HaMelech took 7 years. You know, when Shlomo HaMelech built the Mikdash, 7 years, and many nations helped him. You know, Shlomo HaMelech, as we know, he was the smart חכם מכל האדם, smartest of all people in the world, and the reason he married, he had 1,000 wives, 700 wives and 300 concubines, is to make peace with the whole world, so everybody helps him. Because all of the kings and all the tribes, they all says, oh, this is my father-in-law, this is my chatan, I'm a mechutan, what he needs, I'll help. And that's exactly what happened. Many nations, even, you know, Columbus is not really discovered America. Columbus just rediscovered America. Shlomo HaMelech knew all the lands of the world. He's sending a fleet of boats that went, you know, for an example, the land of Ophir, it's called, Eretz Ophir, it's America, okay? And he sent to South America, into India, into all, even to Australia, that was discovered just 150 years ago. Shlomo HaMelech knew exactly and what path to send the boat in order not to lose and, you know, be a part of a storm. He knew exactly the dates and to bring them back. It's amazing chokhmah. But it says here, Shlomo HaMelech says that a person that rush to do a mitzvah is like building the temple. And we saw that with Herod. By the way, the Kotel, many people don't know, just the portion of the Kotel itself is 57 meters. The whole thing is 500 meters. So it's just a tenth of what you see today. What was broken and destroyed and everything, there was 500 meters of wall. And Herod's, with the Jewish knowledge of the Chachamim, understood that they don't need to put any cement or any metal. They just laid stones, heavy stones. They created such an amazing, today even, nobody can even lift kind of stones. They say that today, with all those giant cranes and everything, they never realized how these people could do such amazing building. You have the stones of the base, even below, which you don't see, are almost like a size of semi-trailer. Imagine this, one stone, and chiseled to perfection, and they place them in a way about almost 2 inch from each other, so just they give such a layer without putting any cement in between. It's such an amazing thing. But let's continue. Continue the Ramchal, he says, that's V'chen darshu al Moshe, alav ha-shalom, even Moshe Rabbeinu, al shemiher b'melachat ha-mishkan. You know, Moshe Rabbeinu, it was what we call, HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, anav mikol adam, it was avdi. Avdi means Elohim in Gematria, 86. He says, he was so close to me, that even when I told him that, you know, you're not going to come to the land of Israel, when somebody says you're going to die, right? Hashem says to him, you know, in Parashat Devarim, by the way, is only 36 days, the whole parasha. Moshe Rabbeinu did not start, you know, gathering his things and, you know, doing a wheel and talking to his wife and kids and saying goodbye. He started teaching Torah, writing the Torah, 13 sets, to give every tribe, to keep one. And also when Hashem says to him, you know, I want you to, you know, take this, do your, you know, build the, you know, the Mishkan. The whole Mishkan was done in literally 70 days from what we call Tedvav Besukot, from the 15th of Sukkot, 70 days it was done. Why? Because Moshe Rabbeinu was such a beautiful love to do it that everybody was so inspired. And that's why Moshe says at one point, enough, we have enough. Imagine, I'm, you know, as a rabbi, you know, of a kollel, I come to you, I said, please, no more donation, I have enough. People gave so much from this result of a mitzvah. That's never going to happen again. You know, today, any shul, every rabbi, they say, oh, no, more, we need more, we have problem, we need more. We don't need more. We have everything we need, Baruch Hashem. You know, this kollel, we don't need anything. Not even donation. We just need you to learn Torah. Just be with us every day. Go on our website. We have hundreds of classes there, both written, both audio, both, you know, visual, videos. Just learn Torah. Hashem take care of the rest. Really, very important. This is what we learned from Moshe Rabbeinu. He says that he never, ever stopped for a second. He was working 70 days. He was the conductor with Bezalel and Aholihav, you know, the 13-year-old kids that Hashem put Ruach HaKodesh behem. And it says, וכן תמצא כל מעשיהם של צדיקים תמיד במהירות. It says, you always see that צדיקים rush to do a mitzvah. It says about Abraham, we learned that from our fathers, forefathers in Abraham, וימהר אברהם אוהלה אל שרה, he rushed when he saw the angels. ויאמר, מהרי, you use the word, you know, hurry, hurry. ויתן אל הנער וימהר. We see that הקדוש ברוך הוא We learn from Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu אפילו הכל עשה בזריזות. שבאו אליו המלאכים, when the angel came, he says, וימהר אברהם אוהלה, rush to his Sarah. He says, rush, make, עשי לנו עוגות. By the way, that was ערב פסח. That was the יודלת בניסן, when the angels came to visit Avraham. ויתן אל הנער. This נער is none other than Ishmael, ימח שמו ושם זכרו, וימהר, and rush. And when רבקה, רבקה, you know, the זריזות of רבקה, he said, ותמהר ותער כדדה. He said, she rushed to come back, you know, and feed and give water to Eliezer, I'm sorry. You know, Eliezer was Eved Avraham, but Eliezer, by the way, just a footnote, he was the son of Nimrod. Nimrod, Arasha, was the king of the world back then, and he wanted to kill Avraham, throw him into the fire. And Avraham says, בוא נעשה התערבות, אם האלוהים שלי הוא האמיתי או האלוהים שלך. Avraham says, let's see whose God is real God. And whoever is... You know, if I die, I die. If not, you convert. You become Hebrew. And they agreed. And Nimrod, as we know, threw him into the pit, the fire. And Hashem says, "Echadu be'olami, ani matzilo." Hashem personally saved Avraham. And Avraham came to Nimrod. Now many thousands of people watching this. And Avraham says to Nimrod, now you need to become Hebrew. We promised, we had an agreement. So Nimrod says, no, but I'll give you my son, Eliezer. And that's exactly what Eliezer became such a tzaddik. אחד מעשרה אנשים שעלו השמיים לבלי למות. Eliezer was one of the 10th that went up to the heaven, like Eliyahu Navi and Serach, without dying. Tzaddik gamur. Rivka rushed to give him. He said, גם לך וגם לגמליך. You know, when Eliezer says to Rivka, השקיני נא מקדך, הגמייני נא מקדך. There's 5 times. Eliezer keep repeating the same thing, 5 times, both to Rivka and to her brother and to her father. First, when he came, when her father was killed by the poison, he tried to kill Eliezer. What's Ashkeni Mekadech? You know, Eliezer was so impressed with Rivka. Rivka knew the Chaf Dalet Sefarim. She knew the whole Torah. You know, the Torah has Chaf Dalet. He said, Ashkeni Mekadech, give me water from the Torah. She taught him Torah, and she was the daughter of Lavan, a 3-year-old. He said, "Ashkinia mikadech, michaf dalet ha-sefarim," from the Torah. She knew she was a prophet even at a young age. "Vatemahera isha," she rushed. "Milamet shekol maaseim shel tzadikim b'meirut, shelo itnu efsek." You're not allowed to chaz v'chalila lasot efsek. When a person gives you a mitzvah, rush to a mitzvah. Always rush. "Lamid lizdarez la mitzvah." And ואשר לא ייתנו הפסק זמן, לא אלא התחלת המצווה ולא שלמתה. Don't have in between, you know, breaks. When you do a mitzvah, start and finish it. They say, שכרה לאלה שגומריה. מי שמסיים את המצווה, like if let's say you started a mitzvah, and you know, you help an old man build a sukkah. You put one wall, you know, you ask somebody else to come and help you. The person that finished the sukkah, he's the one that got the mitzvah. You didn't get it. But, you know, יש בן איש חי, he says, there is no, אין כזה דבר חילוק מצווה לחצי חצי. If you help somebody do a mitzvah, right? And the mitzvah that they do, you also get the same mitzvah. It's not 50-50, you got 100% each. As long as you had the kavana and the will and the, in a way, and there's rizut to do it. The בן איש חי, ככה משלימים את המצווה. המתחיל במצווה, אומרים לו גמור. ותראה שהאדם אשר תלהט נפשו בעבודת בוראו, ודאי שלא יתעצל בעשיית מצוותיו. And you see a person that's really zealous to Hashem, like Pinchas. We see parashat Pinchas coming. He was such love to Hashem that he was willing to sacrifice his own life. And look, he became Baruch Hashem ברית שלום כהונה לעולמים. When you have a zealousy to Hashem, תלהט is from the word להט. להט is, we know, is what we call the burning sword that Hashem hid Gan Eden. Alahat ha-mitapechet. You know, there is, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu punished Adam HaRishon and Chava, many people don't know that, but there is 7 worlds. Yishnam 7 olamot mitachat la'olam shelanu. You know, Adam was thrown down all the way to the darkest place on earth. Inside we have 7 earth. There is 7 olamot. You know, there is a whole thing, it's in the Zohar, in... If I'm not mistaken, Lamed Tet, and also in Bereshit Chet, and of course many in the Gemara. Because the sin of Adam, he was thrown to a place that was all darkness. It's called Eretz. We are live on Tevel. There is the world of Eretz, then Adama, then Tzia, then Sniya. There is all kinds of worlds below. By the way, that's where you know all the aliens, Kol HaChayzarim, Kamim, Mitachat. They said that Adam was in darkness, and the only light he would see every now and then, זה החרב המסתובבת, המתהפכת. Hashem, as we know, he hid Gan Eden with the sword that turns, and every time it turns, it makes light. And the light that Abraham, Adam HaRishon saw was flickering light. Only after he did the tshuva, on Motzei Shabbat, he started the tshuva. That's when Hashem showed him how to make fire. And that's why we do Havdalah. עושים הבדלה בשבת, מוצא שבת, כי זה פעם ראשונה שהאדם ראה את האור. Okay, from the darkness. And of course we know that even Cain was there, and Cain did תשובה, and he went to another world, and another world, and another world. The Gemara also speaks of it. I did a class about it, we'll do another class one day. So let's continue. It says that a person, אשר תתלהט נפשו, that he has such a burning desire to do everything that Hashem will ask him to, עבודת בורו, he says, "Chaz v'chalila v'day shelo it'atzel." A person like this will never be lazy. You know, when you have atzel, what's atzel? Atzel comes from the word tzela. When you atzel, you're tzolea. When a person is not doing everything fast, I mean, they're doing it very slow. Like a person, chaz v'chalila, if his leg is broken, they don't walk right. Right? They're slow. He says, "Chaz v'chalila." That's like how the person that don't do mitzvah, you become tzolea. Chaz v'chalila. He says here. אלא שתהיה תנועתו כתנועת האש המהירה. You know, fire consumes very fast. You know, אש, fire, the only thing it needs is oxygen. Right? And we know, Baruch Hashem, today we have oxygen. It's a miracle of miracles. Many people have to have oxygen, they carry with them all day. Can you imagine how many things you have to say to Hashem? כמה תודה צריך להגיד רק על החמצן? He says here, this is... לא ינוח ולא ישקוט עד כי לה הדבר להשלימו. Don't ever rest until you finish the mitzvah. ואומנם התבונן, and pay attention, התבונן שהזריזות היא תולדת ההתלהטות הפנימית. This is really the תולדה. You know, we have what we call תולדה, and then there is av, avot תולדה. You know, it says that the mitzvah is the avot, but the זריזות is תולדה of the love to do the mitzvot. So בעזרת השם, I have to finish this class. I want to thank you all for being online. תודה רבה לכל מי שהצטרף אלינו. זהו פרק שישי ושביעי של מסילת ישרים. השיעור הזה בעזרת השם יהיה על האתר שלנו. We post this on our website, nesatora.org. My name is Rabbi Dahan, יד התלמיד, here in San Diego, La Jolla. קדוש ברוך הוא, have a wonderful Shabbat for you. Tomorrow in the Kollel we have a special class. We do the series of the prophets. בעזרת השם, at 11 o'clock, I know in Israel is already Shabbat, so by the way, we only do everything. And as far as work concerned, nobody works for any Friday, because we don't want to chaz v'chalila do chilul for anybody. So our class will be here 11 a.m. for בעזרת השם, all the you know people in America and the people in Israel will watch it after that בעזרת השם on מוצאי Shabbat. שיהיה לכם Shabbat Shalom, and remember, be like Pinchas. As we say, Ka'ayal ta'arog, right? Ka'ayal ta'arog, be like the deer. Hashem is a deer. Why Hashem is Ayil? Ayil is the only animal that sleeps with one eye open. The chaya sheyeshena im ayin ptucha v'tamid sama lev l'akol. So be'ezat Hashem, you pay attention to, be zarish le'mitzvot. Toda rabba, and we mentioned tzedakat atzil mimavet. This is times, yemei ben ha'metzarim, do a lot of mitzvot, so you can, v'hasigua, then you can reach your part in the heavens and understanding of Torah. Toda rabba. Have a wonderful rest of the day. Laila tov.